first degree. Premeditated homicide. That is the most serious charge tried in our criminal courts. You have heard a long and complex case, ladies and gentlemen, and it is now your duty to sit down and try to separate the facts from the fancy. One man is dead. The life of another is at stake. If there is a reasonable doubt in your minds as to the guilt of the accused, then you must declare him not guilty. If, however, there is no reasonable doubt, then he must be found guilty. Whichever way you decide, the verdict must be unanimous. I urge you to deliberate honestly and thoughtfully. You are faced with a grave responsibility. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Gum. You want some gum?
Thank you, but no.
You know something?
I know lots of things. I'm an advertiser.
You know something? It's really hot in here.
Gee, I would have known that if you didn't tell me. You?
I suppose not. I sort of got it.
All I've done all day is sweat.
Oh, I bet you aren't sweating like that kid who just got tried, huh?
Why do they ask everything in a place like that? I almost dropped dead in court today.
Hey, buddy, my taxes are high enough.
Yes, it is high.
Okay, everybody's here. If you need anything, I'll be right up here.
Right. Are you locking that door?
Yes, I am.
Or what do you think we are?
Crooks? Well, they lock us up for a little while.
I didn't know I locked that kid up forever. That's fine by me.
I never knew they did that.
I'm sure they locked the door. What'd you think?
Just didn't know. It never occurred.
Shall we all admit right now that it's hot and humid and our temperature?
It's been a pretty hard week.
Oh, I feel just fine.
I'm starting to wonder what's been going on down in my office, you know? You know how it is in advertising. In 6 days, my job could be gone. And the whole company, too. They aren't gonna like
this. Well, figure this is our due pay.
I'd object to doing my duty. I just mentioned that I might not have a job by the time I get back.
Well, why don't you ask her to hire? I mean, she's rich. Just look at that suit.
Yeah, that ass off the rack.
No, it's not.
You know, I have an uncle's adjustment.
How did you do?
Not too well, you know. This friend of his, though, you know, my uncle, the dresser, he wanted to be in the jury at my place.
Why didn't you let him? I would have done anything to get off this gig.
And get caught or something? You know what kind of a fine you can pay for something like that? Anyways, this friend of my uncle, he was on a jury just like this one, about 10 years ago.
So what happened?
They let him off reasonable doubt.
Oh.
And do you know they found out about 3 years later he actually did it? A murderer was turned loose in the streets.
Well, did they get him?
They couldn't.
Why not?
Man can't be held in double jeopardy unless it's a hung jury. They can't try a man twice for the same crime.
Don't worry, baby. That's not gonna happen to you.
6 days. They should have finished it in two. Should we hear so much talk about nothing?
Well, I guess they're entitled.
Oh, right. Everyone gets a fair trial.
I just like that story about the knife. You guys ever hear a phone of your story?
Oh, look, you've got to expect that. You know what you're dealing with.
The kid bought a switchblade then.
Of course.
Tennessee lost it.
A hole in his pocket?
A hole in his father.
A tough way to kill your father.
Look at the kind of people they are. You know them.
Cold or something?
Well, Lulu, these summer colds can kill you.
I had one of those last year on vacation, too.
All right, everyone, why don't we take our seats? You can sit in a number of your jury rooms.
All right.
This better go fast.
2, 3. This way or this way?
Stop. And then we go 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12.
Yeah. Let's get out of here kind of early. I got things to be at tonight.
Oh, really? I haven't seen them last week.
How'd they do?
I think the Orioles.
They lost last year.
Yeah.
I went to the East.
Let's get started.
Okay. How about sitting down? The gentleman at the window, how about sitting down?
Oh, sorry.
It's real tough to figure, isn't it? The kid kills his father. Big, just like that. Oh, come on, it's the element. They let kids run wild. That's true. It serves them right.
There are better proofs than some emotion you may have. Like for some group?
Hey, we all agree it's hot.
And that our tempers would get you.
I think we disagree, but this is open and shut, so let's get it done.
All right, now you guys can do this any way you want. I mean, I'm not here to make any moves. If you want, we can talk about it for a little while, then vote, or we can vote right now.
Why don't we just vote?
All right, anyone doesn't want to vote?
Well, let's see who's wearing it.
That was easy.
All right. All those voting guilty, raise your hands.
Always one.
Now we know where we stand.
Do you really think that he's not guilty?
I don't know.
How can you see?
I cannot tell you. This is ABC.
I don't think it's as simple as ABC.
Well, I never saw a guilty man in my life.
What does a guilty man look like? He's not guilty until we say he's guilty.
Now, you sat right in court and heard the same things I did. The man's a dangerous killer. Anybody can see that.
Where do you look to see if a man's a killer?
You know.
I would like to know. Tell me what the facial characteristics of a killer are. But maybe you know something I don't.
Look! What is there about the case that makes you think this boy is innocent?
He's 19 years old.
Well, that's old enough. I mean, he knifed his own father 4 inches into the chest. A little innocent 19.
I agree with you. The boy is guilty, but let's avoid emotionally colored arguments.
All right, well, they proved it a dozen ways. You want me to list them all?
No.
All right, do you believe that stupid story he told?
Now, now.
Do you believe the kid's story? Of course not.
I don't know whether to believe it or not. Maybe I don't.
What'd you both have guilty for?
There were 11 votes for guilty. It's not so easy for me to raise my hand and send a boy off to die without even talking about it first.
Who says it was easy for me?
Or me.
He's still just as guilty whether it's an easy vote or a hard vote.
That's right.
I think the kid's guilty. You couldn't change my mind.
I don't want to change your mind.
Just what are you trying to do?
I want to talk for a while. Look, this kid's been kicked around all his life. You know, living in a slum. His mother's dead since he was 9 years old. Spent a year and a half in an orphanage while his father's doing a jail tour for forgery. It's not a very good head start. You know why some kids get that way? Because we knock them over the head once a day. Every day. I should think maybe we owe him a few words. That's
all right. It's hard, sure. It was hard for me. Everything I fought for. I worked my way through college. That was a long time ago. And perhaps you do forget, I fought, yes, but I never killed.
I know what it's like. I mean, I never killed anybody.
I've been kicked around too, you know. Went to work the advertising agency business, and the big boy that buys the advertising walked into your office.
Right.
We all know that. Oh,
in Europe, kicking with a science. But let us try to find something better.
I don't mind telling you this, mister. We don't owe that kid a thing. He got a fair trial, didn't he?
Yeah.
You know what that trial cost? He's lucky he got it. We're all grown ups here, am I right? You're not gonna tell us we're supposed to believe him, knowing what he is. I've lived among them all my life. You can't believe a word they say. You all know that.
Well, I don't know that.
Oh my God.
What a terrible thing for a person to believe. Since when is dishonesty a group characteristic? You have no monopoly.
All right, it's not Sunday. We don't need a sermon.
What she said is very
dangerous. I don't
see
any need for arguing like this. I think we ought to behave properly.
Right.
All right.
If you
would.
Thank
you. Sure. We're going to discuss this case, but let's discuss the facts.
Right. That's enough. We got a job to do. Let's get it done.
If you don't mind, I'm going to shut the window. It's blowing on my hands.
Window.
If you don't mind, I think we'll have the window open.
But it was blowing on my hands.
Oh, come on. Don't you want a little air? It's summer. It's hot.
But I was very uncomfortable.
There are 12 of us in this room, lady. If you don't mind.
I have some rights to.
So do the rest of us.
Couldn't you trade chairs with someone at the other side of the room?
All right. I will open the window. If someone would trade.
Take my chair.
Thank you.
All right, can we get back to the case now?
Right, let's. Come on.
I may have an idea. Now, I'm just thinking out loud, but it seems to me that it's up to the 11 of us to convince this gentleman that we're right and he's wrong. Now, maybe if we just talk for a minute or two, you know, try it on for size.
That sounds fair enough. Right. Supposing we go once around the table.
Okay, let's start it off.
All right, that means we start with you.
It's hard to put into words. I just think he's guilty. I thought it was obvious.
In what way was it obvious?
I mean that nobody proved otherwise.
Nobody has to prove otherwise. Innocent until proven guilty. The burden of proof is on the prosecution. The defendant doesn't have to open his mouth. It's in the Constitution. Fifth Amendment. You've heard of it.
Everyone has.
Well, sure, I've heard of it. I know what it is. What I meant, well, I just think he's guilty. There was a witness, so somebody saw him do it.
No reasons, just guilty. There's a life at stake here.
Why don't we get down to the facts? Number one, let's take this old man who lived on the second floor of the apartment, right underneath where the murder took place. At
10 after 12 when he led the killing, he said he heard loud noises. To him, it sounded like a fight. He then heard a boy say to his father, "I'm going to kill you." He then heard a body fall. So he looked out the door of his apartment and saw a kid running downstairs and out of the house. He then called the police, and they found the father with a knife in his chest. Now, these are the facts. I mean, you can't dispute these facts. Now, I'm as sentimental as the next one. And I know that he's only 19, but he's still got to pay for what he's done. That's what I think.
I'm with you, Pops.
And I'm trying to fix the time of death around midnight.
Right, now what else do you want?
It doesn't seem to fit.
The boy's entire story is flimsy.
The whole thing is
it. He claimed he was at the movies. That's a little ridiculous, don't you think? He couldn't even remember what picture he saw.
You hear that? She's absolutely right.
Yeah,
right
there. Ticket stub.
Who keeps a ticket stub at the movies?
I suppose, but the cashier didn't remember.
Now look at the ticket.
What about the woman across the street? If her testimony don't prove it, then what does?
That's right. She saw the killing.
Hey, can we go in order,
just a minute. Here's a woman who's lying in bed and can't sleep. It's hot, you know? Anyway, she wakes up and looks out the window, and right across the street, she sees the kid stick the knife right into his phone.
That's what she saw.
How can she really be sure it was the kid if she saw through the windows of the passing elevated train?
She's known the kid all his life. His window was right opposite hers across the L tracks. And she swore she saw him do it.
I did hear her swear to it.
Okay! And they proved it in court that you can look through the windows of the passing L train at night and see what's happening on the other side. They proved it!
Weren't you telling us just a minute ago that you can't trust them? That you can't believe them?
So?
Then I'd like to ask you something. How can you believe them? Jeez, one of them too, isn't she?
Pretty smart.
Whoa, no, right, calm down! Calm down! Take it easy! Calm down! Everything's fine. Sit down. Relax. What are you letting her get all upset for? I mean, come on.
Listen. We went to the woman's apartment and we looked through the windows of the passing L train, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
And were we able to see what happened on the other side?
I didn't see as well as they told me I would see, but I did see what happened on the other side.
All right, now they're down.
Calm down. It's your turn.
I'll pass.
All right, that's your right. How about you? Old man and boy around 7 o'clock that night? I mean, I could be wrong.
Well, I think it was 8 o'clock, not 7.
That's right, 8 o'clock.
Yeah. Dave heard the father hit the boy twice and then saw the boy walk angrily out of the house.
Right?
Okay, what does that mean?
Doesn't exactly prove anything. It's just part of the picture. I didn't say it proved anything.
Is there anything else?
Well, I guess it's my turn, isn't it?
I don't know. Most of this has been said already. I think we're just wasting our time.
I don't.
Neither do I. Come on.
Look at the kid's record. He was arrested for mugging, they picked him up for stealing a car, and I think they said he stabbed someone.
He did.
At 15, the kid's in reform school for knife fighting. Let's remember he's real good with that.
Right, they sent him to that reform school for stabbing someone.
This is a very fine boy.
Ever since he was 5 years old, his father beat him up regularly. He used his fists.
So would I. Not a kid like that.
You're right. It's the kids. It's the way they are. You know, I've got a kid. He was 8 years old. He ran away from a fight. I was so ashamed of him. I told him, I said, "I'm going to make a man out of you, or else I'm going to bust you up dry." When he was 16, we got in a fight. He punched me in the face, right here. He's big now. You know, I've seen the kid in about 4 years. That rotten kid. I hate those tough kids. I mean, if you work your heart out for him, and... Well, you know, yeah. So
we're missing the point here. This boy, let's say he's a product of a filthy neighborhood and a broken home. We can't help that. We're not here to go into the reasons why slums are breeding grounds for criminals. They are. I know it, and so do you. The children that come out of slum backgrounds are potential menaces to society.
Exactly. I'm only part of it.
I lived in a slum all my
life.
Now,
wait a second.
I nursed that trash 6 nights a week in a hospital. I used to play in a backyard that was filled with garbage. Maybe it still smells.
Oh, come on now, pal. She didn't mean anything personal.
There's something personal. Oh, sit down. You too. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. All right. Now, she wasn't talking about you.
What was she talking about?
I can understand sensitivity.
All right, come on now. Let's stop it.
We're wasting time, everybody.
Right. It's your turn.
Right.
All right. I had a peculiar feeling about this trial. Somehow I felt that the defense counsel never really conducted a thorough cross-examination. Too many questions were left unanswered.
Well, it doesn't change my opinion. I agree the defense counsel was bad.
This is the point.
So what?
So many questions were never answered.
Well, what about the questions that were answered? For instance, let's talk about that cute little switchblade. You know, the one that fired up my kid admitted.
All right, let's get it in here. I'd like to look at it again.
I don't see why we have to look at it. We all know what it looks like.
The gentleman has a right to see evidence.
Fine, make it quick.
This switchblade is a pretty strong piece of evidence, don't you agree?
I do.
Now let's get the sequence of events right as they relate to the switchblade.
The boy admits to going out of his house at 8 o'clock after being slapped by his father.
Or punched.
Or punched! The boy went to the neighborhood store and bought a switchblade. The storekeeper was arrested the following day after he admitted selling it to the kid.
That's right. I think everyone here agrees that's quite an unusual knife.
The storekeeper identified the knife and said it was the only one of its kind he had ever seen. Why did the boy get it?
He says it's a present for his friend. I say it's a present for his father.
Am I right so far?
Right.
You bet she's right.
Next, the boy claimed that on the way home, the knife must have fallen through a hole in his coat pocket. And that he never saw it again. Now there's a story. You know what actually happened. The boy took the knife home. A few hours later, stabbed his father with it, and he remembered to wipe off the fingerprints. Everyone connected to the case identified this knife. Now, are you trying to tell me that someone picked this up off the street, went to the boy's house, and stabbed his father with it just to be amusing?
No, I'm saying that it's possible that the boy lost the knife, and that someone else stabbed his father using a similar knife. It's possible.
Take a look at that knife. It's a very strange knife. I've never seen one like it before. Neither had the storekeeper who sold it to him. How aren't you trying to make us accept a pretty incredible coincidence?
I'm not trying to make anyone accept it. I'm just saying that it's
possible. And I'm saying that it's not possible!
Maybe the reason the cashier didn't see him was because he sneaked into the movies. And maybe it was ashamed to say so. For anybody here who didn't sneak into the movies once or twice when they were younger?
I didn't.
Really? Not even once?
We didn't have movies.
Maybe he did go to the movies, and maybe he didn't. And he may have lied. Do you think he lied?
That's a stupid question. Sure, why?
Do you?
You don't have to ask me that. You know my answer. He lied.
Do you think he lied?
Wait, what are you thinking? The kid's lawyer? There are 12 of us in this room that think he's guilty. If you want to be stubborn and have me stirred, he'll be tried again and found guilty. Sure as he's born.
You're probably right.
Then what are we still doing here? We could be here all night.
It's only one night. A man may die.
All right, can we get on with it now?
Let's. Well, what are you saying? You're the one holding us up in here.
Obviously, you don't think the boy is guilty.
I have a doubt in my mind.
But you haven't presented anything to us that makes it possible for us to understand your doubt. The old man downstairs, he heard the
voice. The woman across the house, I think she saw it.
We know we bought a switchblade that night, but we don't know.
The kid and his brother had a fight that night.
He's been a violent one all the way. While that doesn't prove anything.
Still,
I've got a proposition to make. I want to call for a vote. sure as to vote by secret ballot. I'll abstain. If there's still 11 votes for guilty, I won't stand alone. We'll take in a guilty verdict right now.
That's it.
That's it.
If you didn't, everyone would start.
You gotta enforce the law.
Too many things.
When you see, hear stories about innocent men who have gone to jail or death, then sometimes, years later, things turn up.
Yeah, but then on the other hand, some killers get turned loose. They squeeze out some technicality and kill again.
Listen now. Well, it's enough for me.
It's enough for me, too.
Well, I don't think we could have heard it.
Maybe the old man didn't hear it. I mean, the other one.
Are you calling the old man a liar? Why would he lie? What does he have to gain from lying?
Attention, maybe.
Oh, you keep coming up with these bright sayings. Why don't you send one to a newspaper? They pay $5.
What does that have to do with the man's life? Why might the old man have lied? You have a right to be heard.
It's just that I looked at him for a very long time. The seam of his jacket was split under his arm. Did you notice that? He was a very old man with a torn jacket, and he carried two canes. I think I know him better than anyone here. This is a quiet, frightened, insignificant man who's been nothing all his life. He's never had any recognition. His name in the papers? Nobody knows him after 75 years. This is a sad thing. A man like this needs to be recognized, to be questioned, listened to, and quoted just once. This is very important.
And you want us to believe he made up this stupid story just so he could be important?
Well, no, he wouldn't lie, but perhaps he made himself believe that he heard those words and he saw the voice.
Well, that's the most fantastic thing I've ever heard all day. Why would he make it up? Why are you making it up?
I'm not making it up.
Of course you make it. People don't lie about things like that.
He made himself believe that he told the truth.
What do you know about it?
I speak from experience.
What?
I am that person.
I think we understand now. Thank you.
All right. Well, if you want to be your liar, that's fine by
me. That's too much.
She just said she was a liar.
The circumstances that we could understand why the old man might apply. There is a difference.
A liar is a liar.
Please, have some compassion.
We have our jobs and our duties to do here.
I think they've covered it.
Well, we have.
All right, is there anything else?
Cough drop?
No, thank you.
Does anybody want a cough drop?
Come on, let's get on the table.
You're the pill, Wade. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. I think we proved that the old man couldn't have heard the voice say, I'm going to kill you.
I disagree.
But suppose the old man really did hear the voice say, I'm going to kill you. This phrase, how many times have each of us used it? Probably hundreds. If you do that once more, Junior, I'm going to kill you. Come on, Rocky, kill him.
You say it every day.
Close doesn't actually mean we're going to
kill
someone.
Don't the circumstances alter that somewhat?
The old man was murdered.
Well, one thing more. The phrase was, I'm going to kill him. And he screamed it at the top of his lungs.
That's the way I understand it.
Right. Now don't just stand there and try to tell me he didn't mean it. Anybody who says a thing like that, well, they mean it.
All right, well, let me ask you this.
What?
Do you really think that the boy would shout out a thing like that so that the whole neighborhood would hear it? I don't think so. He's much too bright for that.
Excuse me, bright? He's a common ignorant slob. He don't even speak good English.
The boy is clever enough.
I'd like to change my vote to not guilty.
Why?
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
The vote is 9-3 in favor of guilt.
I'd like to know why you changed your vote.
There's the knife.
Fuck the knife! Don't you want to believe in a fairy tale?
Go on. Give us the reasons.
The old man, too. Maybe he didn't lie, but then just maybe he did. Maybe the old man doesn't like the kid.
Oh, this is the end.
I believe that there's a reason.
What are you basing it on? Stories of this guy pulled out of thin air? The kid had a lawyer. Why didn't the lawyer
take it? Think of everything.
Oh, brother. And you were the one that's sitting here pulling the stories out of thin air. We're supposed to believe the old man didn't get out of bed, run to the door and see the kid book it downstairs 15 seconds after the killing?
That's what I understand.
And the old man lied just so he could get attention?
The old man said he ran to the door.
Oh, what is it now?
Rand walked. He got there, didn't he?
I don't remember what he said, but I was the only one.
He said he went. I remember it now. He said he went from his bedroom to the front door. Not the kid.
Where is this bedroom again?
Down the hall, somewhere.
Down the hall? Why would you send a man off to die because it's down the hall somewhere?
I thought you remembered everything. Do you remember that?
No, I don't.
I don't remember either.
Mr. Foreman, I'd like to take a look at the diagram of the apartment.
Fine. Why don't we run the whole trial over? Everyone can get everything straight.
The bedroom is down the hall somewhere. Do you know? Do you know exactly where it is? Please, a man's life is at stake. Do you know?
Mr. Foreman, I heard you.
Now, what's this one for? How come you're the only one in this room that wants to see exhibits all the time?
I see this one too.
So
I. And I want to stop wasting time.
Are we going to start waiting for all the nonsense about where the body was found?
No. We're going to find out how the man who's had two strokes in the past 3 years and walks with a pair of canes can get to the front door in only 15 seconds.
He said 20 seconds.
He said 15.
Well, as you know how long he is. I mean, he can't judge a thing like that.
He said 15.
He's an old man. How can he be sure about that stuff? He was confused half the time. How can he be sure about anything? Well, you know.
I don't know. Maybe you know.
Yeah, that's it. Thanks. You want this?
Yes, please.
Do me a favor. Wait up. This is over.
Look at that diagram for 2 hours. Enough is enough.
Some of us are interested. Go ahead.
All right. This is the apartment in which the killing took place. The old man's apartment is directly beneath it and exactly the same. Here are the L tracks. The bedroom. Another bedroom. The kitchen. The bathroom. The dining room. And this is the hall. Here's the front door to the apartment, and here are the steps. The old man says he was in this room. He says he got up, went out into the hall, down the hall, to the front door, opened it, and looked out just in time to see the boy racing down the stairs. Am I right so far?
Right.
Yeah.
15 seconds after he heard the body fall. His bed was at the window. It's 12 feet from his bed to the bedroom door. The length of the hall is 43 feet 6 inches. He had to get up, get his canes, walk 12 feet, open the bedroom door, walk 43 feet, and open the front door all in 15 seconds. Do you think this is possible?
No, it's possible.
Yeah. I don't see why not.
He would have been in a hurry. I mean, he did hear the scream.
Yeah.
He can only walk very slowly. They had to help him.
You make it sound like such a long walk. Well, it's not.
An old man keeps his canes. It is a long walk.
What do you think you're doing now?
Let's see how long it's going. I'm going to pace off 12 feet, the length of the bedroom.
You're crazy. You can't recreate anything like that here.
Perhaps if we could see it. This is an important point.
It's a ridiculous waste of time.
Let him do it.
Hand me a chair, please, son. Okay, thank you. All right. This is the bedroom door. How far would you say it is from here to the water cooler?
I'd say it was 20 feet.
Just about.
20 feet is close enough. All right, from here to the water cooler and back is about 40 feet. It's shorter than the length of the hall the old man had to move through. Wouldn't you say that?
A few feet, maybe.
This is absolutely insane. What makes you think you can do this?
Oh, we can't stop!
Do you mind if I try? According to you guys, it'll only take 15 seconds. I think we can spare that.
All right,
who's got to watch with the second hand?
I have.
Well, you want me to start, stamp your foot. That'll be the body part.
Okay, we'll sign it from there.
We'll say he keeps his canes at his bedside, right?
Sure.
All right. Okay, I'm ready.
I'm waiting for the hand to be at 60.
Far be it for me to call anyone a liar, but even a liar for a big difference in time between the two of us. Still, there's quite a
discrepancy.
It's my guess that the old man heard someone racing down the stairs and assumed that it was
assumed? Now listen to me, you people. I've seen all kinds of dishonesty in my day, but this little display right here takes the cake.
What dishonesty?
You come in here with your heart bleeding all over about that swamp cave and injustice. Meanwhile, you got some old lady over here listening. Well, I'm not. I'm getting real sick of you. Hey, what's the matter with you people? I mean, come on. The kid is guilty. We're letting him stoop to our fingers.
Slip through our fingers? Are you his executioner?
I'm one of them.
Perhaps you'd like to pull the switch.
Well, this kid, better let you pull that switch.
I'm sorry for you.
Don't start with me right here.
What it must be like to want to pull the switch.
Shut up.
You say this to me.
Shut up.
You want to see this boy die because you personally want it, not because of the facts.
Shake!
All the caller votes out. Those stand to win.
All right, that sounds fair. I vote guilty. Number two?
Not guilty.
Three?
He's guilty.
Four?
Guilty.
Five?
Not guilty.
Six?
Not guilty.
Seven?
Guilty.
Eight?
Not guilty.
Nine?
Not guilty.
Ten?
Guilty.
11?
Not guilty.
12?
And that's why you changed your vote, and why you changed your vote, and why you changed your vote. There are six men in here who think a murderer may be turned loose into the streets. Emotion won't do. Why?
Right? The father, but stabbing someone is like shooting. No. When you're stabbed, you're still moving around. You're writhing maybe on the ground.
That's quite possible.
Right.
There would have been enough oxygen assistance to carry him for two or three seconds, I should think.
Wouldn't the father have cried out?
Well, maybe the kid held his mouth.
That also seems possible.
Also, there's another point we might bring out. Anyone who is clear enough mentally to wipe fingerprints off the knife, well, that person is also clear enough mentally to look around the apartment, or the room in this case, to see if there are any other clues. It would just be for a second or two, but still, he would look.
There you have it. This gets better and better.
We're trying to make it clear. One doesn't talk about quality when a murder is involved. Let's do it.
Well, wait. About this with the fingerprints. The murderer wiped fingers off the knife. Well, what about the doorknob? I mean, a man was coming into my house, a man that hated me now. And he was wiping the doorknob with a handkerchief before he came in. So I don't know about you guys, but that would give me a funny feeling. So that must have been done afterwards. And this, too, would take some time.
True.
Can you tell the last one? Why don't you tell this one, too?
All right.
Take your foot when you want me to start.
I want the hand to be at 60.
I'm going to kill you!
This does tend to confirm the story of the old man, but in part, he is now a proven liar. And this is by your own admission.
That may be true, that the old man lies in part, but I think I'll change my vote once more. Guilty.
Right. And what do you think about this now, huh?
Not too sure what I think. I want to talk some more, because at first I thought guilty, and then I changed, and now I'm sort of swinging back to guilty.
All right, and how about you? What's your opinion?
No, I am in real doubt now.
I say guilty. I was right the first time.
All right. Now we can even make some sense in
it. Okay, it seems to be about 9 guilty to 3 not guilty.
One more question about the old man downstairs. How many of you live in apartment buildings?
Look, I do not know what you're thinking, but I know what I'm thinking.
What?
I do not live in a tenement. But it is close enough, and there is just enough light in the hall so you can see the steps. No more. And this murder took place in the tenement. Remember how we stumbled on the steps?
The police officers were using big balls, and one even had a flashlight.
An old man who misjudged the time by 20 seconds. On this we all agree. This old man looked down the dark hallway of a tenement and recognized the running figure.
He was 100% wrong about the time. It took twice as long as he thought.
Could not the old man be 100% wrong about who he saw?
That's the most idiotic thing I've ever heard of. Where do you come up with these things?
Do you truly feel there is no room for reasonable doubt?
Yes, I do.
I beg your pardon, but perhaps you do not understand the term reasonable doubt.
What do you mean I don't understand? Who do you think you are coming over here talking like this? You come over here running for your life before you can take a big, deep breath, you're telling me how to run the show? The arrogance!
No one here is asking for any
love. I was born right here.
Where your father came
Maybe from. It wouldn't hurt us to take a few tips from people who come here. We're not so perfect.
Please, I am used to peace. It's all right.
It's not all right!
Fine. I apologize. Is that what you want?
That's what I want.
All right, come on, guys. Let's stop arguing.
Who's got something constructive to say?
Well, something's been bothering me a little bit. This whole business about the stabbing, the
situation right here. Someone in this room get up. All right, now, I want you all to watch this very carefully. I'm not going to do it again.
Whoa!
Sent to reform school for knifing someone. Isn't that so?
That's right.
Look at this. Doesn't it seem like an awkward way to handle a knife?
What are you asking me for?
Wait a minute. What's the matter? Give me that gun.
Have you ever seen a knife fight?
Yes, I have.
In the movies?
In my backyard. Sitting on my porch, I see the vacant lot across the street. Too many of them. Switchblades came from the neighborhood where I live. Funny I didn't think. I guess you try to forget those things. Anyone who's ever used a switchblade will never have stabbed down. You don't handle switchblades like that. You use it under.
Then he couldn't have made the kind of wound that killed his father.
I suppose it's conceivable that he could have made the wound, but it ain't likely. Not the kid had had any experience with switchblades. We know that the kid had a lot of experience with switchblades.
Well, I don't believe it.
And neither do I. This guy's giving us a lot of mumbo jumbo.
What do you think?
Well,
what about you?
Listen, I'm a little sick of this whole thing already. Why can't we just pack it up and go home?
Before we decide anything more, I want to try and pull this together.
We have it.
We don't have an adversary. Let's see. I'm used to taking shots and pulling things together. Let's, chip up a few shots. See if anything lands on the ground.
I want you all to look at this logically and consistently.
Wasting time.
I want to know.
Just get smart.
Or is he dumb?
What are you talking about?
This is a kid who's gone to reform school for knife fighting. On the night of the murder, he bought a knife. A switchblade. It would then take a very stupid kid to go and murder a man, his father, with an instrument that everyone would associate with the kid.
I quite agree, and he is dumb.
However, if you were dumb, then why did he make the kind of wound that an inexperienced man would make with a knife?
I'm not sure I understand.
To murder someone must take a great emotion. Great hatred. And at that moment, he would handle the knife as best as he could. And a trained knife fighter would handle it as best as he'd been trained. Underhand. A man who had not been trained would go overhand. But the kid is very smart. Everyone knows that he's an experienced knife fighter. So he's smart enough at that moment to make the kind of wound that an amateur would make. That man is a smart man. He was smart enough to wipe the fingerprints away. Perhaps he was smart enough to wait until an L-train was going by to cover the noise. Now, kid's smart, or is he dumb?
Now, wait a minute.
Well, the woman across the L track saw the murder through the L train, so someone in that train could have seen the murder too.
A possibility, but no one did that we know of.
It would take an awfully dumb man to take that chance, doing the murder as the train went by.
Exactly. A dumb man. A very stupid man. A man swept with emotion. He probably heard nothing. He probably didn't even hear the train coming. And whoever did murder those women, the father did it as well as he could. The kid is dumb enough to do everything to associate himself with Switchblade. A Switchblade murder. And then a moment after the murder, he becomes smart. Now, is this kid smart? Or is this kid dumb? To say that he is guilty, you have to toss his intelligence like a pancake. There is doubt, doubt, doubt. And the old man downstairs, on the stand, he swore it was 15 seconds. He insisted on 15 seconds. But we all agree that it must have been almost 40 seconds.
Does the old man lie half the time and then tell the truth the other half?
For the kid to be guilty, he must be stupid, then smart. For the kid to be guilty, the old man downstairs must be a liar half the time. And the other half the time, he must tell the truth. You can reasonably doubt.
Well, he'll get me out of here sooner. I'm so lucky.
Another vote call for. I guess the quickest way would be a show of hands. All those voting not guilty, raise your hands. Nine. All those voting guilty. Three. The vote is 9-3 in favor of Clinton.
I don't understand you people! How can you believe this kid is innocent? You know how those people lie, I don't have to tell you. They don't know what the truth is. Let me tell you, they don't need any real big reason to kill someone either. You know, they get drunk and bam, someone's lying in the gutter. Nobody's blaming them, that's how they are. You know what I mean, don't you? Violent! Human life don't mean as much to them as it does to us. Where are you all going? These people are drinking and fighting all the time. And if somebody gets killed, so somebody gets killed. They don't care? Sure, there's some good things about them. Not a few were pretty decent, but that is the exception. No feelings. All right, what's going on here? I'm speaking my piece. You better listen to me. They're no good. There's not one of them who's any good. Take it from me, this kid on trial, don't you know about them? Listen to me!
I've had enough of you in this rant. If you open your mouth again, so help me God, I'll split your skull.
That's what we're trying to tell you.
All right, sit down, everybody. I still believe Floyd's guilty beyond a reasonable doubt, and I'll tell you why. To me, the most damning evidence was given by the woman across the street who claims she actually saw the murder committed.
That's what I mean, to throw out all this evidence.
Frankly, in view of this, I don't see how you could vote for acquittal.
The whole case right there.
What do you think about it?
Well, maybe, but...
Maybe? But like I said, you could throw out all the other evidence.
That was not appealing. I don't deny the validity of the points he has made. Can we say that on one side of the tracks there's doubt? But what can you say about the story of the woman? She saw it!
What time is it? 10 minutes after.
You don't suppose they let us go home early and finish this in the morning, do you? I bet a kid home with mumps.
Yes, she's taken tomorrow morning.
Can't you see your watch without your glasses?
Not clearly.
Glasses are a nuisance.
Well, what do you all do when you wake up at night and you want to know what time it is?
I put on my glasses and then I look at the clock.
And when I bed, wake the clock to chime.
Do you wear your glasses to bed?
Of course not. Nobody wears their glasses to bed.
The woman who testified that she saw the killing wears glasses. What about her?
Did she wear glasses?
Of course. The woman wore bifocals. I remember them very clearly. They looked quite strong.
That's right. Bifocals. She never took them off.
I think it's logical to say that she was not wearing her glasses in bed. And I don't think she put them on to casually glance out the window. She testified that the murder took place the instant she looked out the window, and that the lights went out a split second later. She couldn't have had time to put them on then. Now, perhaps this woman actually see the boy kill his father. I say that she only saw him.
Well, how do you know what she saw? Maybe she's far-sighted. But how does she know all these things?
Does anyone think? There still is not a reasonable doubt?
No.
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 I will always wonder. But there is a reasonable doubt.
Oh, I still think he's guilty!
Does anyone else?
No. I'm convinced there is a reasonable doubt.
Tell you what. I'll tell you what. Now,
11 votes not guilty. One. Guilty.
I don't care what I'm I'm entitled to my own opinion. The phrase was, I'm going to kill you. And the boy said it to his father. Now, I don't care what kind of man he was. It was still his father. That goddamn rotten king. I know what they are. I know what they do. I know how they can kill every day. My God, why can't you just make these people see? Why am I the only one who I can feel this knife going in.
Well, there's nothing we can do about that. Except that some night, maybe a few months, why, you might get some sleep.
You're all alone.
It takes a great deal of courage to stand alone.
If it is a hung jury, there will be another trial, and some of us will point these things out to the various lawyers.
All right.
They're waiting. Not guilty.
Not guilty.